Hello, I'm Dr. Ruffin. I'm a professor in aerospace engineering at Georgia Tech, and I'm also associate chair for the undergraduate program. Really excited that you have interest in our program. I'd love to tell you a little bit more about that in this virtual information session. As we go through this, I'm going to go through a few slides, and I'll be joined by Chris Lundy, who's the academic advising manager. He's part of our team that helps all of our current students navigate through the program and lead to really good, successful opportunities. I want to talk a little bit about what aerospace engineers do, talk a little bit about our program, what our students study, what types of things they do in the classroom and outside the classroom, and then finally, how to connect with our program, find out more, and to talk with us. So one of the first things is, what is aerospace engineering? So aerospace engineering is the study and development of systems that fly, and this can be through the aircraft, through air, or through space, or some combination of them. So if you look at the slide here, you'll see sort of a collage of different types of aerospace systems. You'll see conventional aircraft, either for commercial or military applications. You will see aircraft that are rotary wing aircraft. Some of them are helicopters, such as this. You will see spacecraft that operate just in space. Some that come back from space and they re-enter Earth's atmosphere or explore other planets, and then the types of crafts that get you from the ground into space. But this also includes other subsystems like aircraft engines, rocket engines, unmanned aerial vehicles. Here's a very small one that flaps. Missile systems and a variety of other types of vehicles and systems. Overall, what aerospace engineers do is design, build, analyze, and improve all types of flight systems. This includes rotorcraft, unmanned aerial vehicles, aircraft, spacecraft, and all types of other systems. What we're really seeking to do is to improve efficiency of such systems, safety, their ability to really make a difference and make a positive difference, and all types of other things that we're looking for. Efficiency, safety, and ability of these systems. For example, if you look at a fixed-wing aircraft, some of the things we might be doing is looking at ways to create lower design, lower drag wings, quieter, more fuel-efficient engines using composites, and development of autonomous systems that will either work with the pilot or even without the pilot to provide a safer, more efficient flight. Also, for example, if you look at a launch system such as this, we may be looking at high energy fuels that can get us to take off and land using less fuel, more environmentally friendly. You know, some spacecraft now will launch vertically and land vertically. We can launch vertically and land horizontally. So how do these transitions occur? How do we make this safe, cheap, and very efficient? So where do our students go to work from Georgia Tech? So our Georgia Tech aerospace engineering students go to a variety of places. If you look at the list at the top, these are aircraft manufacturers. So these are companies that most of us have heard of, Lockheed Martin, Boeing, Airbus, and companies like that that put a final fixed-wing aircraft together. All of the NASA centers, we have students that intern or go to work for each of the NASA centers, plus the other companies that work a lot with NASA, such as NASA's Jet Propulsion Lab and Aerospace Corporation. Our students go work for all of the engine companies. We have a number of particular areas of expertise, and engine systems and design are several of those. There are a variety of commercial space companies, Blue Origin, Orbital Sciences, Boeing, Virgin Galactic, SpaceX, and others as well. Our students are interning and going to work at these really exciting agencies. Helicopter and rotorcraft manufacturers, each of the government defense agencies has research labs, airlines, and then the final bullet here at the bottom, in addition to these companies, most of them you've heard of, but there are hundreds of other companies that do work that will be designing components and building components to support these others. If you add up these hundreds of other companies, this means lots and lots of additional jobs. This is sort of what aerospace engineers do and where they tend to go work. I'd like to start talking now about the program here at Georgia Tech. It is phenomenal. So if you look at just the rankings of our program, we're ranked at number one in the world in aerospace engineering by U.S. College Factual. Our undergraduate program is ranked number two in the country by U.S. News and World Report. We're very excited about these really high rankings, and our graduate program is ranked number four. If you're interested in Georgia Tech, you're interested in a great university because all of our engineering programs are extremely highly ranked, and aerospace engineering is very much so as well. The other thing I'll point out here quickly at the bottom of this, how are we funded? Now, you may not be interested in that, but I want to tell you why that's important. But if you look at the faculty, like me and the other faculty, we are here designing and carrying out a curriculum that helps you learn. But most of us are doing research as well, too. We're working with companies and private industry about what's coming next, creating ideas using phenomenal students here. So the sponsored research funding that you see, that's about $32 million a year. What that goes into is developing high-quality facilities for our students to use so they can learn, and so our undergraduates and graduate students can get involved in current research opportunities and really create and innovate. Georgia Tech is all about creating and innovating, and there's a lot of that here. A couple of other things about our program. We are a large program. We have tremendous impact because of a couple of reasons. Because of our rankings, companies seek us out heavily because they know this is a high-quality program where great students are. They also know that we are a large program. So if you look at Georgia Tech's impact in aerospace engineering nationally and in the world, it's quite substantial. We have approximately 1,000 undergraduate students in our program and about 500 graduate students. This means expertise all across the fields within aerospace. This means expertise both breadth and depth in many different areas. So about 45% of our students are from in-state, the rest out of state. About 12% are from countries outside the U.S., 18% underrepresented minority, and about 20% women. And if you look at this plot, and rising, and we're happy that we're rising, we're looking to provide a very high quality and increasingly diverse workforce. One of the other things I can say about the program, you'll see on this slide some information about the average GPAs of students that come in based on their high school GPA, ACT scores, and SAT scores. So if you're interested in this program and you join this program, you're going to be working alongside really outstanding students. This is a plot of the number of students that apply to our program each year over the years, and you see that it's getting quite large. So why is this number rising so much? Why do we have around 3,100 applicants to our program? Again, it's because the word has gotten out to industry, employers, and others that this is a great place to get an education and producing great engineers. Our acceptance rate in the program is about 16%. One other thing I want to talk about here is I've talked a little bit about jobs, and we'll talk a little bit more about that as well. But our students do internships and co-ops, most of them all over the country and in many places in the world. This is just a sample of where some of our students went on a recent summer. You'll see the types of places here. Some of them are places you might imagine, NASA centers, aerospace companies as well. You'll see NASA Ames here, SpaceX, NASA JPL, Northrop Grumman, a lot of the places you would expect. Some other places, perhaps you haven't, a variety of consulting agencies and others. So our students will work both in aerospace engineering, and some of them will work in other fields as well. So next, I'd like to have Chris Lundy come up. Remember, he's the academic advising manager. He'll tell you a little bit more about our program.
Hi, my name is Chris Lundy. I am the undergraduate academic advising manager for the School of Aerospace Engineering. And again, we want to thank you again for your interest in our program. As Dr. Ruffin mentioned, we have a lot of students who are interested in internships and co-ops, and ultimately they lead to employment. And this right here is an example of our employment for our students. So students have reported an annual salary of about $73,950 $50. A lot of students will stay and get a graduate degree, and as you can see, that will increase compensation based on that master's degree. We have also a lot of students who will stay and get PhDs, and their compensation will increase as well. So we're very excited about the opportunities that our students are provided and the compensation that comes along with it. Obviously, they have to go through our program first, and so this is our curriculum. We have a lot of students who will start very early in terms of getting advanced credit, so things like IB, things like AP, dual enrollment, all of those will go into it as well. So our admissions team will evaluate that, and classes will be appropriately applied. We have some students who will come in with no credit at all, and we'll have some students who will bring in a lot of advanced credit. And so it's up to us as the admissions team, as well as the academic advisors, to determine where those classes will appropriately be placed. We have a lot of classes here where students will get a lot of hands-on experience, and also students will have opportunities to do a lot of research experience with these classes as well. So we have a great combination, healthy combination of students who will do a lot of different things in terms of hands-on experience and research experience. So our program is 132 credit hours. And as you can see, here's a breakdown of what that looks like between our humanities, math and sciences, and technical courses. We provide a lot of our students with options courses, free electives, health and physics, and some AE requirements as well. We have a lot of students who take advantage of the AE options courses. Those courses do rotate every once in a while, and so it's important as academic advisors that we sit down with our students who are very interested in these options courses to figure out if they qualify or not when those courses are ready for either fall or spring semester. We also have a lot of students who take advantage of the free electives through minors. Some popular minors are computer science, physics, mathematics, architecture, and foreign language like Russian. We also provide our students with specialty areas, and so with our specialty areas, that provides students with an opportunity to kind of tailor their program just a little bit more using those AE options. At some point, our students will have opportunities in all 10 of these areas, but they don't have to come in and choose anything like a concentration. So our students are not an aerospace major with a concentration in aeromechanics. As I mentioned, students will have opportunities in all of these areas, but our AE options and our math option will provide students an opportunity just to tailor things a little bit better when it comes to, excuse me, when it comes to their curriculum. So what do some of our students do outside of the classroom? Well, some of our students are provided with certain things like our design, build, fly opportunity, design, build, fly lab, and that ties in very well when it comes back to our humanities and social sciences and our math options and our AE options. Our students are learning a lot of different things and using a lot of different labs to actually put things together through design, build, fly lab, or through things like our machine shop or our aero makerspace. They are constantly going back and forth between those areas to design, build, fly, and analyze an airplane and meet it to certain specifications so that they're able to take that to a specific competition. We have a lot of students who are interested in study abroad and international plans. Our study abroad opportunities in aerospace include Limerick, include Lorraine, and we've recently started a program in India. So we highly encourage our students to take advantage of those programs. A lot of the upper division courses are offered through those, and for our out-of-state students, they can pay Georgia Tech in-state tuition to take advantage of these opportunities. We highly encourage our students to get involved in a lot of different disciplines. Just to highlight a few of these student organizations, our Yellow Jacket Flying Club is pretty popular. By the time our students graduate, our students would actually have a pilot's license if they join the Yellow Jacket Flying Club. Sigma Gamma Tau is our AE Honor Society. A lot of our students work with them in terms of, in addition to us being academic advisors, they talk to a lot of our students about what it looks like to pair certain courses together. And so that helps our students out tremendously. Our Women of Aeronautics and Astronautics actually puts together programs where they'll help a lot of our freshman women. Our upper class women will work with our freshman women in terms of helping them in the machine shop, for example, to learn a lot of the different machinery and how to appropriately apply it. So just to kind of review what myself and what Dr. Ruffin have done, again, we are a very, very highly ranked program, and we strongly encourage all of you to apply to our program. We strongly encourage opportunities for research. We strongly encourage opportunities for our students to stay and get a master's degree. We strongly encourage our opportunities for internships, co-ops that will ultimately lead to employment, Our faculty members are great. They want to work with our faculty. They want to work with our students in a lot of different areas and a lot of different disciplines, and helping them with career fair opportunities, again, internships and research opportunities, and getting them to where they want to be and where they see themselves in the field of aerospace engineering in the future. We strongly encourage you all to connect with us via social media. And again, we want to thank you all very much for your interest in the School of Aerospace Engineering at Georgia Tech.